This is a local gospel choir coming up to the entrance of the hospital where Nelson Mandela has been now for 3 full weeks, offering their prayers, offering a song, bringing white balloons as well. Since we've been here, we've seen this on a regular basis. Choirs, official government groups, political groups, even school children have come here and done the same exact thing, thanking Nelson Mandela for all he has done for the country, a man considered to be the father of the democratic post-apartheid nation. Now, for the media camped out here, it's been quite a challenge to cover such a sensitive story without access to what's happening behind this gate. This is one of two entrances where we are based. The other entrance on Park Street, though, has been a bone of contention for one of the Mandela daughters. His eldest daughter, in fact, lashed out at some in the international media for being vultures, for divulging what she says were gory details about, you know, specifics, what's happening to Nelson Mandela's internal organs and what the status of his life support is. So it poses quite of a challenge for not just local journalists, print and broadcast, but international media as well, as everyone here tries to feed the massive appetite for information on Nelson Mandela while still respecting his privacy. He's a private citizen. His family, of course, is going through a very difficult time, and they're steeped in tradition as well. They're following Tembu Xhosa tradition, in which it's taboo to talk out loud about the impending passing of a respected elder or about any of those controversial or divisive topics that the family may be grappling with. So we've seen some of that emerge here at the end of the third week, but still without a clear sign of what will happen to Nelson Mandela, this media presence really isn't going anywhere.